He's the man behind, next to, and often under Elmo. Please welcome Kevin Clash! Thank you very much, because this isn't something you get to do all that often, on the other side.
Once in a while, I was on Oprah, Oprah Winfrey Show, and that was fun. So they saw me then. I was revealed.
Now, do you have...
Elmo doesn't understand who this man is.
Do you have a lot of difficulty convincing people that you are Elmo?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, I took my daughter to a store one day, and she said, my dad's Elmo. And they were like... And I did the voice. And they were like, okay, I can do it better. They didn't believe me, so I stopped telling people what I do. Another thing I try to do is I talk lower. You know, when you get to know, you know, when you see who I am, it's like, hi, yeah, I do Elmo. Just to make the mystique a little bit better.
Now, you must find that even in this situation, like, I can't help but look, when Elmo looks at me, I have to look,
sure,
look him back in the eye. Do you find that...
Elmo's cuter and handsomer.
What is it about the entire, not just Sesame Street, but Muppet characters that makes them so real to people?
Well, I just think the fact is, you know, we're humans. We're ordinary. Mm. I mean, you know, to see something like this, you know, up close and personal like this, it's different. So, of course, your eye is going to more focus on him than on what you normally see day to day. So
with the, like, children who come to often, you know, perform on Sesame,
sure,
Street as well, like, how are they the first time they see someone connected to their favorite character?
I mean, well, you know, we have a lot of celebrities come in. Like, if you would come in or what have you.
Or a celebrity.
You know, we tell them that, you know, because they say, well, we have children, we would like to bring them in. And we'd say, well, a child keeps their imagination a lot longer than we think. And so they can bring them in, and they normally don't look at me. They just look at me as like somebody that's carrying around their favorite friend. And that's really what it, especially with kids, they keep their imagination, so.
And of course, one of the most distinctive character traits Elmo has is his laugh.
Yes.
Now, how much of that was brought to the character by you, and how much of that was already existing?
Well, it's funny, talking with Frank Oz, you know, when how he got Fozzie Bear is when he started doing waka, 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 you know, or Piggy saying mwah. You know, those traits you can get in the character, and that gets you in the character. So, I mean, the laugh was very important with Elmo.
So it was. I hear initially it wasn't something that people warmed to straight away.
Well, one of the producers at the time, she took me out to lunch and said, you know, he's cute, but he just laughs too much. And then, of course, Tickle Me Elmo came out, and that all got kiboshed at that point.
Yeah. Now, you're also a talent scout for Sesame Street Workshop in particular.
Yeah.
So what do you look for when you're out scouting for future puppeteers?
Well, I mean, I was taught by Jim Henson and Frank and everything. So it's really about, you know, how to make the character come alive. And the voice is normally secondary, which people are really surprised about. You know, and they when they meet me, they say, oh, you do the voice of Elmo. And I said, no, we don't separate it. We're performers, so we perform the character and we do the voice.
And then, you know, are there people who would see this as a proper profession? Like, is it something that initially you went, I'm going to be a puppeteer?
Yeah, you know, actually I did. I was either going to do animation with Disney or be a puppeteer. Because I grew up watching Sesame Street and Kukla, Fran and Ollie, which was a children's program that was on in the States. And I always wanted to do it. Always did. And my mom and dad, they knew that. They really supported me. My mom sewed a lot, so she helped me sew on the sewing machine when I was young. And, you know, I got teased in school. You know, you sleep with puppets, blah, 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 blah. And then, you know, I got my first local television show, and then everybody was like, wow, that's cool. And then, of course, I did a lot of shows, like variety shows and stuff, and I got to heckle, you know, those people who put me down about it. But, you know, I mean, I always enjoyed what I did, and I didn't deal with peer pressure, and so I just stuck with it.
And
Elmo, like, died right there. He talks and Elmo just loses it.
Now, what I love is that... He's all right. He's still there. What I love is that... You mentioned the Tickle Me Elmo doll. Yeah. Elmo's had some very popular toys. We had the Chicken Dance Elmo,
yes,
which we loved. And we got a new one now. This is the Elmo Knows Your Name one.
Sure.
Now, this has been programmed. You can program all various information on people in it. And this one has been programmed on me.
Yes.
With Rover in there. So we'll switch him on, and he basically squeezes his hand and he gets all the information out. So we'll turn him on and have a listen.
Hi,
Rover, let's play. Squeeze Elmo's hand.
Okay, and he knows a few things about me, for example.
Elmo loves you, Rover. Elmo loves cereal. Rover does too.
I do love cereal too. I do love cereal. Got like your Weet-Bix? Yeah, Weet-Bix in the morning.
Oh, really?
I'm a bandit for it. What is Elmo's favourite cereal?
Elmo loves wasabi. That's why Elmo doesn't have any eyelids.
Actually, this is very cute.
Please do not... Wasabi is a sunshine food.
Look, these are available now in Kmart and Target. That was very quick correction. Available in Target, and for those of you in the audience who are too lazy, every single one of you tonight gets one to take home. And it didn't even help. Look, I underlined Target.
You underlined it and you said the wrong word.
What is wrong with me?
Yes, what is wrong with me? Well, your wife is not here.
There's something very wrong with me. Please say Kevin Clash and Elmo. Blushing.